Imagine if there is something that can make you a better musician right now. If somebody could break music down into smaller components so that you could understand it much easier and apply it more creatively when you're playing. This is what happened to me the first time when I understood the concepts of rhythm, and I was surprised at how easy it is. It can be learned within minutes. I still remember how overjoyed and excited I was when I first understood rhythm and the potential of it to be applied to create so much more exciting and creative music instantly without knowing any other new stuff. You too can do that, so stick around. In this lesson, you are going to learn about the basics of rhythm guitar and how it can be applied to your instrument to make anything you're playing much more creative. Welcome back everybody, Dhanesh here, learnguitaronline.in, and in this lesson, we are going to be studying the basics of rhythm and how you can instantly become a better musician by applying rhythm more creatively. Before we talk about rhythm, let's understand why rhythm is so important to learn. According to me, and I'm sure according to most musicians, rhythm is one of the most important elements of music. One of the main reasons being rhythm shows up in every other element and contributes to its enhancement. Whether it is melody, harmony, texture, timbre, you name it, rhythm will show up everywhere. Rhythm is not something new to you. At a subconscious level, you know rhythm. I know that when you were in school, you used to bang your desk. Whenever you listen to your favorite music, you go ahead and start tapping your foot, or you clap your hands, or you bang your head, or you groove to the beats. Whatever your way of expressing was, I know that rhythm is already inside you. So you have an understanding of rhythm. What we'll do now is we'll break it down into small concepts and musical terms, which are very easy to understand. And once you get these down, no matter what instrument you play, you will instantly become a much creative player once you practice application of this. Now, we spoke about grooving to music, banging your head or clapping your hands. What you will observe is every time you do this activity, there is a consistent interval between each of those movements that you're making. Whether it is clapping, whether it is banging, whether it is tapping, doesn't matter. You will find there's a consistent interval going on. This interval is called as beat in music. You can think of it like the pulse of music. And just like how the pulse in your body keeps going up and down depending on your activities, beat can also vary its pace. It can be faster, it can be slower, it can be at a moderate pace, and this pace in music is known as tempo. Now I want you to think of music as conversation, just like how I'm talking to you right now. I'm taking pauses so that I can ensure that whatever I'm saying you can understand. Just like that, as a musician, you have to ensure that your music also flows in a way that is easy for the listener to comprehend. Which is why music is broken down into different blocks, and each of these individual blocks are called as either bar or measure. Now I want you to think of songs as a period of time that you're going to be dividing into different sections, and you want to make the listener feel different emotions through each of these sections. Each individual measure can be further divided into different groupings of beats. So beats can be arranged within measures in order to make music more interesting. Now, when we arrange beats into one measure of music, there is a certain capacity that a measure has. That is decided by something that we refer to as time signature. Time signatures can be of various kinds, and it's a very vast topic. So right now, I don't want you to get confused thinking about time signature. Just imagine that in every measure, for now, we are going to keep a maximum 4 beats. Time signature is a very vast and at times complex topic. So at this moment, we'll just leave it out from our discussion and we'll focus on beats and the divisions of beats. So what I want you to think of is, for now, our time signature is going to be a maximum of 4 beats in one measure. Now these beats can be further divided into different note groupings, which are going to decide the duration of each and every note within your measure. Now, these note durations are what I want you to focus on for this lesson, because this is the absolute critical element that you need to know in order to make music. Now, the concepts that we are going to discuss are universal to music and doesn't depend on what kind of instrument you're playing. So here is how I want you to learn the note durations. Like I said, for now, we are considering that every measure has a maximum of 4 beats. Now, if you give away these 4 beats to one individual note, the duration of that note is what we call as a whole note. So in other words, a whole note lasts for 4 beats. So if we focus on the beat right now, it's moving at this tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now if you play whole note durations with individual pitches on the guitar with that track, it's going to sound like this. And if you're playing it with chords, it is going to sound like this. So as you heard, we were playing on beat number 1 of the measure and we were sustaining for the remaining 3 beats in that measure. And then we come back and play right from the top on the start of next measure. So that was whole note for you, and the next note duration that you should be familiar with is a half note. Now, as the name suggests, a half note is a half of a whole note. So this is going to get only 2 beats within any measure. Now, with individual notes, a half note is going to sound like this. You can count half notes as 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. So what I just played there sounded like this. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. If we apply the same concept to chords, it's going to sound like this. So there it is, half note. Any guesses what's coming next? You guessed it right, it's a quarter note. If you observed the pattern, half note was a half of a whole note, so quarter note is going to be a half of a half note. So within our space of one measure where we have a maximum of 4 beats, a quarter note will get only 1 beat. So if you're going to fill up that measure with all quarter notes, that means you're going to be playing on every beat now. You can do the counting as 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. And with melodies and rhythm, a continuous stream of quarter notes is going to sound like this. I am sure by now you're getting a hang of this. Even if you don't know how to play guitar, how to play any instrument, this is so simple and easy to understand. So let's keep going. There is one more note duration that I want you to learn today, right now, which is an eighth note. And like we have seen the pattern so far, an eighth note is going to be half of a quarter note. So now, if we want to arrange a measure of 4 beats into eighth notes, we'll have to divide each individual beat into 2 equal parts. Now, doing that on the guitar becomes much easier because we use something called as alternate picking, where we do downstroke on one of the notes and upstroke on the next note. So a simple stream of eighth notes played melodically will sound like this. So what I'm doing over there is I'm making this down up movement continuously to get my eighth notes right. So I can divide each individual beat into 2 equal parts this time. And that goes something like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... So within one measure of 4 beats, we are playing 8 times because we have divided each beat into 2 parts. We can apply the same thing to rhythm guitar as well. So as you saw, again I was doing my down up movement, which we learned during the strumming lesson, and that is what easily allows me to create the sound of 8th notes. Now when you study rhythm, I don't want you to think of them as individual entities, whole note, half note, quarter note, 8th note. Think of them as members of one family and how they contribute to each other. For example, in one measure of 4 beats, you can have just one whole note. Whereas if you replace that whole note with half notes, then you can have 2 of them. And what if you want to divide the next half note into 2 parts? You can have one half note plus 2 quarter notes. What if you want to divide the last quarter note into 2 equal parts? You will have a half note, a quarter note, and 2 eighth notes. And this is what makes rhythm interesting. This is how you create more interesting music without knowing any new stuff. And you don't need the guitar to practice this stuff. You don't need any instrument at all. You can do this anywhere. First thing I highly recommend is for you to learn how to count these rhythms. And you can use any kind of counting method. You can go by what we discussed, which is whole notes 1, 2, 3, 4, half note 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, quarter notes 1, 1, 1, 1, and eighth notes as 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and, or 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus, where you're not only playing on the numbers, you're also playing on the syllables. Or you can use any method that you want. You can use some syllables like ta, 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 pa, pa, whatever comes best to you, you can use that to understand rhythms. Now music becomes more interesting when you start combining these together. For example, if I have a rhythm that goes 2 quarter notes followed by 4 eighth notes, then it will sound like this. Now if I change something over there, if I take out the first 2 quarter notes and instead replace them with half notes, then the rhythm will become like this. What if we replace the 8th notes at the end and add a quarter note over there to the rhythm that we were just playing? Then it will start sounding like this. So I'm sure by now you must be getting excited thinking about the possibilities of applying these rhythms and how easily you can create melodic lines and rhythm guitar parts which sound much more creative without actually learning any new stuff or technique. The same examples that we discussed can be applied to lead guitar also, and creative application of rhythms is going to make your music much more interesting without adding any new stuff to it. Now let's talk about how you're going to practice rhythms. So like we discussed during the strumming lesson, for practicing rhythms also you don't need your instrument. You can do it anywhere. What you can do is write down simple patterns that will fill up a measure of 4 beats. Something like this. So in this rhythm we have a half note followed by 2 quarter notes. Then imagine in your head how is it going to sound, and you can give yourself the counts. You can tap on the bench or you can clap your hands and you can try to sing that rhythm out. It doesn't always have to be counting. Like I said, you can use syllables. You can do something like da 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 da. Write down a whole bunch of these rhythms. Fill up your book, one page, with all different kinds of rhythm combinations. Then the next time when you sit at the guitar, do not do anything with your fretting hand. Don't waste your time trying to get everything together and, you know, waste the precious time that you can instead utilize to get better at rhythm guitar. Just mute the strings or just play with one chord that you are extremely comfortable with, or just play it with open strings, doesn't matter. Remember, your goal when studying rhythms is to get better at using rhythms. So when you get a chance to play your instrument, bring out those, play them on the guitar and find out how each of them sound. And whichever rhythms you like, make sure that you store them somewhere so that you can utilize it when you're writing music in future. So there you have it, absolute basics of rhythm guitar. But the most important takeaway for you is to understand the importance of rhythm in itself and how it contributes to everything else that you do in your song. If you like what you're learning, then smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and turn on your notifications so that you can know every time I upload the next lesson. Let me know through the comment section below about any other topic that you would like me to cover or any queries you have related to rhythm guitar. Share this video with all your friends who want to learn so that you can do your bit to help others. For many such music learning resources, motivation and practice tips, head over to learnguitaronline.in. This is Dhanesh again, and I'll see you at your next lesson.